live here in Lyon, and that is where the final's being played. So every day I drive past, looking at the stadium, thinking that's where England's going to be lifting the trophy. My dad used to have to finish work early. He used to come home, cook my tea, wrap it in tin foil, go and pick me up from the school gates. Here's your tea, eat it in the car. I'd just chill eating sandwich, spaghetti bolognese sometimes. My dad would be the poor guy that had to drive me an hour and a half there, sit and watch in the freezing cold, drive me an hour and a half back. Every time I get told that I can't do this because you're a girl, well, I'll just go and prove that I can, and I'll prove that I can do it even better than you could imagine. When I first joined a girls' team, I played as a striker and I ended up playing all the way back in defence in midfield because I couldn't bear the other team having the ball. When I got in front of the goal, I constantly passed to the person next to me. Then I got put in the midfield and I did the same thing, so I just got put further and further back. Being part of the team and really helping the team is stopping the other team from scoring. That's always what I preferred. I think Lucy Bronze as a footballer is hard-working. Always have been, always will be. I'm probably not the most talented player in the world in terms of technical ability. I think there's a lot of players out there who are maybe better than me, but I think I have a physical prowess that not a lot of people have. Every time you represent England, it's amazing and it's special, and each game is so exciting, and scoring in a big tournament or winning a big game is just the best feeling, you know. You can't compare it. This is a really big moment for women's football. I think everyone that's part of it really recognises that.